Hi, my name is Mel and I'm a full-time eBay seller here in Australia. Now, last weekend I picked up a huge haul, and part of that haul was a free lot of books that I picked up from somebody on Facebook Marketplace. Now, when I got there, she told me she had a couple of boxes that were full of really old vintage books in poor condition, and they were her husband's and they were all about the military. And would I be interested in taking those along with the other books that I collected? So, of course, I said yes. One thing I've learned on this book journey is you must never judge a book by its cover. Now, I know absolutely nothing about military or military books, and I don't actually even know a lot about the vintage books. The vintage books are something that I have to really research every time I come across them, but I'm always quite pleasantly surprised at how much value they do have. So the last few days I've been trying to clear this particular haul that I bought on the weekend. And so today's job was to go through all these old vintage military books and see if there's anything in there that's worth me selling. Now at the end of the day, I picked up these books for free. So really the only thing that I've got to lose is my time that it takes me to comp these books, find out how much they're worth, and then decide whether or not I list these for sale. So I've pulled all these old military books out onto the table and I wanted to go through them with you so that we can learn together and I can see what I've got. Now, I have never sold any of these authors, and there's quite a few here that I only have one book by the same author. So if I was to make a guess on some of those books, I would say they're probably only worth around the $15 mark, including postage. But for me, that's still okay. If I sell a book that's $15 including postage, it basically works out that I'm making a $5 profit on the book. So when I've got all these books for free, I'm more than happy to take a $5 profit on a book. Now, I do have some here. You can see I've got quite a lot of this particular author. His name is William Forstchen. And there's a few of this guy called Jack Campbell. I've got Leo Kessler. You saw me pull those books out on the video the other day. This guy here, Sven Hassel. And I've got some groups here of Douglas Reeman. And now there's a couple of military non-fiction books here, and one of them does look really interesting. So I'm really keen to show you that in a minute and let us comp that together. So now what I'm going to do with these books is I'm actually going to open up my eBay app and I'm just going to type them in and look them up and see how much they are selling for, if there is any other ones that have sold in the last 90 days, and if there's none that have sold, I need to look at any that are listed to try and make out how much value there is in each of these books. Now, one thing that you may be noticing with these books is every single one of these books is in extremely poor condition. They are all very tatty. They are all very old. There's not a lot with foxing, even in these old books, but the pages are discolored. You know, the covers are worn. They are bent at the edges. They are certainly all only in acceptable condition. Now, when I price comp the books, I have to do it right down the end here of the storage units, because right down the end here is the entrance and the lift to where I go out. But this is the only spot where I get decent Wi-Fi to be pricing my books. So I always set the pricing table up here so that I can work out the cost of these books. And I'll come back here and I'll let you know exactly what I've found, how much these books are worth, if there is any hidden gems amongst this lot, and I'll go through and I'll show you exactly how much I'm going to charge for these books. So I've finished comping the books, so let's take a look. Now these two piles are only comping at like $14 or $15, and remember I said that earlier, I thought a lot of the individual books would only be worth around that $15 mark, including the postage. And they are in really poor condition, but I am going to give them a go at the $14 or $15 mark because there are other ones selling. So when I can see that there's actually sold comps of these old books, it tells me that people are still wanting them. So they will still get listed even though they're only smaller profits. But again, like I said, on a $15 book, I can look at making a $5 profit. Now, these ones here, these are like pairs of books. They're going to sell for like $25. There's another one here that I'll put on for $18. A bundle of three here for $20. A bundle of here, I'm going to put that for $25. This bundle I'm going to put for 20. Now these ones are a little bit more expensive. I'm going to list these for 40, 40, 45. Now these ones were comping kind of around the 50 to 69. So I'm going to look those up a little bit more when I get home to the desktop. Sometimes I find that you get a different reading off the desktop than the mobile phone. So if there's ever more of a high-end looking book or a book set, then I always kind of double check it from the phone to the desktop. These ones are going for about 40. That book I'll list for 20. Now this book was a little bit interesting, and this was the book that I thought would be interesting when I first opened it up. This is like a folder, and it contains the day-by-day record from the invasion to victory. And it's like a whole heap of magazines. And it's every single day of the year for the war. So it's a real document. So this has actually been sold quite a few times. A lot of them aren't coming from Australia. So what I'm going to do, there was a variety of prices on that that look like they're going from about $48 to $89. So because that's quite a variable range, I am going to research that again a little bit harder when I get home. But I'm estimating, you know, around that $50 mark, which is a great price for a free book. And another couple of individual books here, $20 and $35. Only two books are going in the waste. This one's cover was totally fallen off. This one was comping only at about $14, but it's got pen on it. It's, you know, it's absolutely shocking condition. It is got a little bit of sticky tape here as well, so I'm not even going to bother listing that. So yeah, I'm very happy with these books. I've learned something new. I do always kind of expect that these old small vintage books can pull about $15, and that's why I don't discard them, you know, or rule them out straight away. And they're certainly worth doing their comps. I have sold small fiction books in this horrible type of condition for really a lot of money. So you just never know.
Okay, so I've done a little bit of a tally for you. And as you can see, I got all those books for free. Now I'm going to list those books for a total of $727. It's going to cost me approximately about $200 to post it with Australia Post. Yes, our postage is expensive. I'll have roughly $110 in eBay fees working on approximately 15%, and I'll have about $35 for the cost of the padded mailers. Now let's get real, I'm probably not going to sell 100% of that haul, but even if I had a sell-through rate of 50%, I'm almost making $200 profit for a lot of books that I got for free, and they really aren't going to take me much longer than an hour and a half to 2 hours in total to price comp, photograph, list, send to my virtual assistant, and store. So that's pretty good money for me. That's working on about $100 an hour for free books, and I'm pretty darn happy with that.
So I think we can agree there's money in military books, and I'll certainly be on the lookout for those now when I am sourcing books. If you want to learn more about selling on eBay, then don't forget to hit that subscribe button.